Yes.
Good morning, everyone. Today we'll be discussing some of the myths in the biological sciences. And let me introduce myself, Jitendra Singh Huda, and I will be discussing certain myths in biology. As we know that bio word basically means life. Bio word basically means life. And if you talk about the logi word, that basically means study. So from this particular analysis, we are coming to know that biology is study of life. But this is not the exact thing about the biology. What is not so? Like suppose if we were having a bacteria, and that bacteria was living in one particular period of time, and after that he dies. When he dies, he becomes dead. And if we are studying on the dead bacteria, that will be coming under biology or not? Let's take another example. We have O2, which is very much required for the living organism. Will it come under the study of biology? So this word is pretty not sure to be taken place up in the definition of biology. Instead, we can use two important words. The first one is life forms, and the next one will be life processes, right? So this is the one for the. If you talk about the next thing within the biology, that we inhale, there are two processes. The first one is inhalation, the next one is exhalation. So in the inhalation we take in O2, and in the exhalation we give out CO2. It's also wrong. It's totally wrong. Why it is wrong? Our nose does not have a specific power that in mixture of gases it can take in oxygen only. You are getting my point? So similarly, we are exhaling out air, and the air will be having a good concentration of carbon dioxide, and we are inhaling in air which must have a good amount of oxygen in it. Now, if you go further on with the next very important equation, in the books we used to have the equation of photosynthesis as CO2 plus H2O will give C6H12O6 plus H2O. It will not give us H2O in the books. It will give us O2, right? But exactly, if you balance it up, it will be something like this in the books. But this is wrong. Why it is wrong? Basically, if you take the net equation of photosynthesis, you will be having 12 molecules of water in it, and there will be release of 6 molecules of water in it. So this is the standard definition of photosynthesis. Don't forget to write about CSL. SL basically means sunlight, and CFIL, that means chlorophyll, right? So another myth which I would like to take in today's session is of RBC. Now people say that RBC stands for red blood cells, but it does not stand for red blood cells. Actually, to call a cell, we need to have, to call a cell, we require three important things in it. The first one is the CM. CM stands for cell membrane. Then CP. CP stands for your cytoplasm. Yes. Then this stands for your nucleus. Right? But if you talk about the RBCs, RBCs don't have nucleus in them. So that's why they are not called as red blood cells. They are basically called as corpus cells. I feel that these are some of the myths which I have discussed in today's class. We'll be soon discussing some other myths, some confusions, some questions of the biology which are very interesting. Let me take you with another example from the 9th class. अगर आई आस्क मी अ क्वेश्चन दैट वी हैव टू काइंड ऑफ एंडोप्लाज्मिक रेटिकुलम द फर्स्ट वन इज वी हैव टू काइंड ऑफ ईआर द फर्स्ट ईआर इज एसईआर एंड द नेक्स्ट वन इज आरईआर राइट सो एस स्टैंड फॉर स्मूथ एंडोप्लाज्मिक रेटिकुलम एंड rough R stands for rough endoplasmic reticulum so do we have any interaction not joining between the SER and RER if you might have seen the diagram of nucleus you might have found it something like this if you have drawn the diagram of nucleus in your practical files or somewhere there you might have seen the nucleus looks something like this right so this is the outer nuclear membrane and this is the inner nuclear membrane so there will be a connection of the there will be a connection like this of RER that is rough endoplasmic reticulum but on this side you might have seen some kind of structures like this so do we have any interaction of that particular stuff that means does the SER this is your smooth endoplasmic reticulum is connected with the RER is the SER connected with the nuclear membrane or not right this is a question which I am putting to all the biologists so get will we'll see how we can answer it off how efficiently we can go for the searching processes thank you we'll see you in the next class bye bye